The Republican Party knows that they cannot win without interference from Russia and maybe a voter suppression. They cannot win.
Yeah.
People in this country are against him now. And so they have to have it. And she's a perfect person to throw right in the middle of this. She's a perfect foil.
Democrats seem to score well in some red states like Virginia. They flip both the House and the Senate.
Hold it now.
And speaking of flipping the seat, remember that woman who flipped the bird to Trump?
Oh, wow.
Remember her?
Rally?
Her name was Julie Briskman. She flipped him the bird when his car was going by. Yeah, I know. And so she lost her job because of that.
Right.
She sued her company and won severance from the company.
Right.
Hold it now.
And then she just won. The seat at the Loudoun County Board of Supervisors. Beating the incumbent Republican by 52.4% of the vote. So she not only. I love that.
Nice.
Good for her.
That's a happy ending.
Yeah.
For the bird.
Bitches ain't shit but hoes and tricks.
Let's talk about EU Ambassador Sondland changing his testimony yesterday, that he had to be refreshed about quid pro quo.
Not so good now. Quid pro quo. Do us your bag.
And you've been skeptical more than a lot of the Democrats about the impeachment inquiry. Were you surprised by what he did yesterday?
Well, look, the facts are important. And we'll get to that. I want to start with something that I think is also important about facts, because recently on your show here...
I was just going to get to that.
Good.
Yeah. So what did you think when you heard that?
I mean, for me, honestly, you know, I mean, Hillary's been dead on with so many things. She told us about Russia. She has deep knowledge about world issues. I thought, where's the lie? She's endorsed by, you know, by sort of the Russians.
David Duke.
She has basically renounced that, but she's never renounced the Russian support. There have been about 20 Russian bot websites that have supported her since she's announced her run for the presidency.
She hasn't said anything in her tweets. How dare you? That's outrageous. Of course I'm not. She didn't say that. Mm-hmm. I just think that she could be a useful idiot the way Trump is a useful idiot to the Russians.
Yeah.
That they see something.
Helping you out.
You want me to ask you the question?
Yeah. No, look, some of you have accused me of being a traitor to my country, a Russian asset, a Trojan horse. Useful idiot, I think, was the term that you used. Which basically means that I'm naive or lack intelligence to know what's going on.
They use that.
I want to let your viewers know exactly who I am.
All right.
Set the record straight. I am a patriot. I love our country. I am a strong and intelligent woman of color. And I have dedicated almost my entire adult life to protecting the safety, security, and the freedom of all Americans in this country. It was the attacks on 9/11.
I guess we're getting a little bit far ahead of ourselves, but Franklin Graham finds you refreshing. He doesn't find me refreshing.
Everybody knows, and I'm not a political person exactly, but everybody knows at this point.
Find me refreshing. Richard Spencer, the white nationalist leader, says he could vote for you.
Joy, this is why
I mean, you're on Tucker Carlson at least 10 times. Why don't you go on Chris Wallace's show?
This is why I'm here, because you and other people continue to spread these innuendos shows that have nothing to do with who I am.
Well, Hillary Clinton started it, and then you shot back at her, boy. You called her the queen of warmongers.
You doubled down, unfortunately, you doubled down on the baseless accusations that she made that strikes at the core of who I am. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier.
So.
Really? I mean, this is outrageous. This is outrageous and offensive on so many levels. I've served as a member of Congress now for almost 7 years.
I'm a soldier.
Receiving high-level national security and intelligence briefings, serving on the Foreign Affairs Committee, the Armed Services Committee, the Homeland Security Committee, working to ensure the safety and security of the people of this country. This is why I'm running for president, to continue that commitment of service.
So are you surprised, though, that when people see bots and things and all the things that we've sort of been seeing heading your way, that people have these questions? Because she's not the only one. Hillary, I don't think, is the only one. So. What she's saying is she feels they are grooming you. You're saying nobody's grooming me. I'm doing what I'm doing because I'm a soldier and a patriot.
I'm a soldier.
It's offensive to me as a soldier, as an American, as a member of Congress, as a veteran, and frankly, as a woman, to be so demeaned in such a way.
But you called her the personification of rock.
So demeaned.
She's a woman
in such
too.
A way. Well, I'm pointing to the fact that she has continued this legacy of being the world's police around the world, that has waged wars costing the lives of thousands of my brothers and sisters in uniform. I'm speaking out against that. And
what's
to
your
change,
evidence of that?
To change.
Well, can I?
Are you serious?
Let's hear it.
Are you serious?
Let's hear it.
Do you think she's too quick on the draw, too eager to use military force?
I worry about that. Yeah, I do.
In the last debate, I said that, it was a mistake to trust George Bush, that he would do what he told all of us he would do.
So, yes, I made a mistake. It is his war. They are his mistakes, his misjudgments. That
I made a mistake, plain and simple. And I have written about it in my book.
I do take responsibility for having made what is clearly not the best decision.
You know, I did make a mistake, and I admitted that I made a mistake.
You know, look, that was a mistake, and I've said it was a mistake, and I had good friends like Vice President Biden who were with me. And I guess my greatest regret was voting to give President Bush authority in Iraq.
Did you make a mistake?
I did. And I've said that it was a mistake. Well, as I say in my book, I made a mistake. But I said, look, it was a mistake to vote for that.
Lay out the fact that I made a mistake when I voted to give President Bush authority with respect to Iraq.
Just shows you how hard it is to make these choices, which is why I'm calling the book Hard Choices.
She's just going after Hillary. Mm-hmm. And like you said, Hillary was right about almost everything. She's been exonerated with that nonsense that they pulled about her server already.
That was a mistake. I'm sorry about that. I take responsibility.
Well, using a private server was certainly a mistake, and the secretary's acknowledged that using any kind of personal server, whether it was her own private server or a commercial personal server.
I made a mistake using a private email.
That's for sure.
And if I had to do it over again, I would obviously do it differently. That was a mistake, and I take responsibility for using a personal email account.
But yes, it was an unnecessary vulnerability to use a private server, and the secretary has acknowledged that was a mistake.
I'm not making any excuses. It was a mistake, and I am very sorry about that. But I'm not going to make any excuses. It was a mistake, and I take responsibility for that.
Served in the war
not
in
you,
Iraq.
Not you, her. You're saying that she's,
exactly.
She's a warmonger.
I served
How
in the war in
that?
Iraq
yeah.
that she championed. She championed a regime change war in Libya.
Did you not
in
believe
Libya.
In that war?
I believe the lies that were told to us.
Well, so did she.
It is indisputable. It is indisputable to say anything other than the fact.
Well, this guy
that Hillary, let me just close this out, that Hillary Clinton, throughout her career, has led with a foreign policy of interventionism mm-hmm. and being the world's police, going and toppling dictators in other countries that has caused such destruction and loss of life. I'm against that. I'm running for president to change that. Rather than actually debate me on the issues, she and others are resorting to these smear tactic campaigns, seeking to undermine me, smear my character, and sending a message to anyone who dissents, stand, toe the line, or you too will be smeared.